This is from the Epistle of Blessed Paul the Apostle to the Ephesians. Brethren, to me, the least of all the saints, has given this grace to preach among the Gentiles the unsearchable riches of Christ, and to enlighten all men, that they may see what is the dispensation of the mystery which hath been hidden from eternity in God, who created all things, that the manifold wisdom of God may be made known to the principalities and powers in heavenly places through the Church, according to the eternal purpose which he made in Christ Jesus our Lord, in whom we have boldness and access with confidence by the faith of him. For this cause I bow my knees to the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, of whom all paternity in heaven and earth is named, that he would grant you, according to the riches of his glory, to be strengthened by his Spirit with might unto the inward man, that Christ may dwell by faith in your hearts, that being rooted and founded in charity, you may be able to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth, to know also the charity of Christ, which surpasseth all knowledge, that you may be filled unto all the fullness of God. The continuation of the Holy Gospel according to St. John. At that time the Jews, because it was the Passover, that the bodies might not remain on the cross on the Sabbath day, for that was the great Sabbath day, besought Pilate that their legs might be broken, and that they might be taken away. The soldiers therefore came, and they broke the legs of the first and of the other that was crucified with him. But after they were come to Jesus, when they saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. But one of the soldiers with a spear opened his side, and immediately there came out blood and water. And he that saw it hath given testimony, and his testimony is true. And he knoweth that he saith true, that you also may believe. For these things were done that the scripture might be fulfilled, you shall not break the bone of him. And again another scripture saith, they shall look on him whom they pierced. Thus far the words of today's Holy Gospel. We celebrate today the external solemnity of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. The feast was on Friday, but for more solemnity, the liturgy allows it to be transferred to the nearest Sunday, so we're celebrating today the Mass of the Feast of the Sacred Heart. And this Mass is being offered for all of the parishioners of Holy Innocents Parish. We also wish all of our fathers and grandfathers a very happy and holy Father's Day today. May St. Joseph always be your guide and your model, and bless you and give you the strength and courage to continue leading your families in the way of holiness. You have probably heard by now the good news that in the city of New York, the public masses will be offered beginning tomorrow. And so the mass schedule at Holy Innocents remains as it was, with the two masses in the morning, the two masses in the afternoon, and the Latin Mass in the evening. The exposition of the Blessed Sacrament, the schedule of devotions, novenas, all remains as was. The only slight difference is the confession schedule. For the moment, there will be no confessions during the morning, and the afternoon confessions will be reduced by half an hour. They'll be heard from 12 to 1, and the evening confessions a little earlier, from 5 to 5:30. So this is just for the beginnings. We'll go back eventually to the original schedule. And until further notice, the confessions will be heard in the church all at those times, not in the confessional box. So more information will be available on the website and by email, and also in the parish bulletin. So please spread the word that Holy Innocents will be opened tomorrow for the regular schedule of Masses, and next Sunday we will see, please God, many more people here for our usual schedule of Sunday Masses. Christi on the cross, no doubt. He had been up there, he had been kept up all night, interrogated and being made fun of. He had not eaten or drank anything since the celebration of the Last Supper, the first Mass. He underwent the painful scourging and crowning of thorns, and carried his cross up the hill to Calvary in a very weakened state. And for the path of several hours, he was raised upon the cross, baking in the hot sun, gasping for air, his sacred lips parched like baked clay. But the physical thirst our Lord experienced was nothing in comparison to his spiritual thirst. Saint Augustine said it best, God thirsts to be thirsted for. Our Lord highlighted this by not taking the bowl which was offered to him. Again, Saint Augustine states, on the cross, Jesus said, I thirst. But they didn't give him what he thirsted for. He thirsted for souls, and they gave him vinegar. Venerable Archbishop Fulton Sheen, in his work, The Greatest Calling, wrote, quote, the cry of Christ from the cross, I thirst, refers not to a physical thirst, for he refused the drink they offered him. It was his soul that was burning and his heart that was on fire. He was thirsting for the souls of men. The shepherd was lonely without his sheep. The Creator was yearning for his creatures. Yes, our Blessed Lord was thirsty for our love, for our total dedication to him. It is as if he were saying, I have done everything for you. I have preached my message of salvation for the past 3 years. I have cured your sick and raised the dead. I have offered forgiveness and solace to you. I have left you my precious body and blood in the Holy Eucharist as the medicine of immortality, and now I am shedding my precious blood to the very last drop upon this cross. When our Lord appeared to St. Margaret Mary and showed her his sacred heart, crowned with thorns and all aflame on fire with love for us, he said to that apostle of the Sacred Heart, behold this heart which has loved men so much, but in return only receives indifference and ingratitude. The whole devotion to the Sacred Heart is a devotion of reparation. We are called to quench the thirst of Jesus on the cross, as Mother Teresa of Calcutta always encouraged us to do. The Psalm 62 states, my God, I seek you, my soul thirsts for you, my flesh faints for you, as in a dry and weary land where no water is. Again, St. Augustine states, our hearts are restless until they rest in the Lord. If we are not trying to quench our Lord's thirst, if we are not quenching our thirst with our Lord, then we are going to be going to all types of amusements and sinful pleasures in this life in order to fill that void which is missing. We have restless hearts that must find their rest in the Lord and only in the Lord. And what joy comes when we can make reparation to him, when we can console the Sacred Heart for the coldness, the indifference, and even the sacrileges and blasphemies committed against him. We can quench our Lord's thirst on the cross by living our lives well and in a holy manner, by offering up mortifications and penances, by accepting whatever crosses come our way in any given day, and by being faithful to our duties according to our state in life, whatever that might be, to do our work. cleanse us of our sins. May that be a protection for us and for our families. And may we never have to go anywhere else or look for any more comforts or consolations, but only in that heart, burning with immense love for us. And may our hearts in return burn with immense love for the Lord who loves us so much that he died on the cross to redeem us, and who remains in the Blessed Sacrament today, despite a lot of ingratitude and irreverence, just so he can be close to us, accept our visits, and come to rest in our pure hearts at Holy Communion time. Praise and glory evermore be to the most sacred Eucharistic heart of Jesus. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Thank you. Mater misericordiae.
We humbly ask
Jesus, formed by the Holy Ghost in the womb of the Virgin Mother.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, substantially united with the Word of God.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, of infinite majesty.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, holy temple of God.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, tabernacle of the Most High.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, house of God and gate of heaven.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, glowing furnace of charity.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, vessel of justice and love.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, full of goodness and love.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, abyss of all virtues.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, most worthy of all praise.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, king and center of all hearts.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, in whom are all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, in whom dwells all the fullness of divinity.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, in whom the Father is well pleased.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, of whose fullness we have all received.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, desire of the everlasting hills.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, patient and rich in mercy.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, rich to all who invoke thee.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, fount of life and holiness.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, propitiation for our sins.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, loaded down with opprobrium.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, bruised for our offenses.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, obedient unto death.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, pierced with the lance.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, source of all consolation.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, our life and resurrection.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, our peace and reconciliation.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, victim for our sins.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, salvation of those who hope in thee.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, hope of those who die in thee.
Amen.
Heart of Jesus, delight of all the saints.
Amen.
Lamb of God, who takest away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, who takest away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, who takest away the sins of the world. Jesus, meek and humble of heart. Let us pray, Almighty and everlasting God, graciously regard the heart of thy well-beloved Son and the acts of praise and satisfaction which he renders thee on behalf of sinners. And through their merit, grant pardon to us who implore thy mercy. In the name of thy Son, Jesus Christ, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, God, world without end.
Amen.
Oh, Jesus.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be